This video is how to get a proposal for a research project. Just look at your five fingers, and that tells you the five things you have to do in your research proposal. Look, there's the thumb, the forefinger, the middle finger, the ring finger, and the pinky. T, F, M, R, P. Those are the things that you have to do. And each one of those stands for something. The thumb, T. T stands for topic. Your proposal has to be focused on a topic. Usually that topic is defined by the criterion variable of your study. Then comes F for forefinger. Now, that stands for forecast, and your forecast should represent the hypotheses, the predictions that you want to make. Then comes M for middle finger. That's your method. In other words, your design. How you are going to set up this. Is it going to be sample versus norms, separate groups, perhaps repeated measures, or will it simply be a correlational design? Then comes R for the ring finger. R stands for how are you going to record or recover the data? What are you going to use? A questionnaire, a field count, archives, or perhaps some kind of trace analysis. Finally, there's P for the pinky finger, and that concerns your participants. In other words, your human or animal subjects that you use to get your data. That's the way most people design their proposal, starting with the thumb, forefinger, middle finger, ring finger, and pinky. The topic, the forecast, the methods, recording data, and lastly, deciding on the participants. So, it's thumb, forefinger, middle, recording data, participants. Let me show you a faster way. See how much faster that is? In other words, start with P, your participants. Who do you really have access to? That really narrows it down. Then look at the ways you have to recover data. Look at what method makes sense given the ways you have to recover data. Then develop your forecast, your hypothesis, and that will define your topic. You do it in this order, you will get a proposal and you'll get it done a lot better and a lot faster.